Good evening. I should bow because I'm always teaching my students to do that. When they're slapping, you bow, so there you go. I've done that with that. My name is Dr. Karen Novella. I'm chair of the music department at Brock University. And before we get going, I'd like to read the land acknowledgement. Brock University acknowledges the land on which we gather is the traditional territory of the Haudenosaunee and Anishinaabe peoples, many of whom continue to live and work here today. This territory is covered by the Upper Canada Treaties and is within the land protected by the Dish with One Spoon Wampum Agreement. Today, this gathering place is home to many First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples, and acknowledging reminds us that our great standard of living is directly related to the resources and friendship of Indigenous people. So, welcome, and I don't know if this is the same for you, but this is, with the exception of some very small, closed, private concerts, this is my first concert with live audience since March 2020. I'm so glad you could all be here. And in case you didn't know, it is also being live streamed. So hello, people watching the live stream or watching the recording afterwards. About that, and part of the reason also why I have my phone out, the live stream is also going to be saved as a recording that you can access afterwards. So you don't need your phone. And I know it's been a while since we've been in an audience, but as performers, it really bugs us when we look out and we see people on their phones. So masks on, phones off, and put away. Do you like that? I made that up tonight. Okay. So now, before we get going, I have to thank, I'm not going to thank individuals because there are too many, but at Brock University, there is an entire team of people that have worked together to make this happen, from the people in the publicity office to the people who work together to make sure we have safe conditions for rehearsal and performance for our musicians. So thank you to everyone on the Brock University side. Some of you are here. Thank you so much. And especially to the wonderful professional staff here at the First Ontario Performing Arts Centre. You don't even know how great these people are. I'm so grateful to have the privilege of working with all of them. Thank you to those of you at the Performing Arts Centre. Please thank them with me. Okay, I'm totally gonna forget what I'm supposed to talk about. I talked about the phone, I talked about the thank yous. Now, I'm gonna talk about clapping. So, sometimes people are nervous about coming to classical concerts because they're not sure when to clap. If you're not sure when to clap, don't. Here's how you know. Have a look at your program. Can you tell I'm a prof? Everyone pick up your program. Okay, the first one, Edward Elgar. You have a title, Serenade for String Orchestra in E Minor. Okay, that's the name of the whole piece. There are three movements. What you will be hearing are the three movements. You will be hearing three separate sort of pieces that are part of the serenade. Ideally, we clap at the end of the whole thing, okay? So ideally, after the allegro, which will be a rousing piacevole, after the allegro piacevole, you're gonna wanna clap. Do your best not to, hold it until the end, okay? Then you'll hear the larghetto, which is slow, and the allegretto, which is fast, or like I do when I'm sitting backstage, okay, fast, slow, fast. After the second fast one, then you can clap. If you're not sure, wait for me. I'll be at the back, and I'll clap raucously, and you can join me. And then the second one's easy. That's just one. Okay? And then again, the second half. How long is Brandenburg?
17.
Three. Okay? I know it's 17 minutes. Three movements. Someone's done lots of practicing. Okay, you haven't come here to listen to me. You've come here to listen to the String Orchestra, which is a combination of students and community members. Some alumni are here as well. Thank you so much, all of you, for bringing your hard work, dedication, and showing up every week, making this happen, and being on Zoom rehearsals last year. Guys, that's hard. So without further ado, please join me in welcoming George Cleland and the Brock University String Orchestra.
that we're the first of the ensembles that actually gets to play here, especially after the crazy year that we had last year. But we're so excited, we're so honored to be doing this. Thank you everyone for coming. The first piece that we're going to play is by Elgar. It's the Serenade for Strings, and it's one of the early pieces that showed his brilliance. He was one of the great composers of the early 20th century, particularly in England, where it had a flowering of music. This was one of the early pieces that showed that he was a brilliant composer, and it has a great freshness of youth.
Thank you.
second piece on our program is by Villa-Lobos, and it's the famous Bachianas Brasileiras number 5, which originally was written for a choir of cellos and a mezzo-soprano. And it has a story that there is a girl who's sitting waiting, and she's watching the sky and this beautiful shade of pink that's covered with the moon. And then she has like feelings of she's regret and loneliness and wishing that someone was there in the middle, and it goes back to the moon at the end. Villa-Lobos was the most prolific Brazilian composer. He is also the most famous, currently anyway, Brazilian composer. His music is some form of synthesis between his interest in the native Brazilian music and also European tradition. Although an interesting side note is that he never actually really did formal training. It was all instinctive.
Thank you.
So the third and final piece on the program is the Brandenburg Concerto No. 6, one of a set of six concertos that Bach wrote as a gift to the Margrave of Brandenburg. The unusual instrumentation in this is that it's all low-sounding voice string instruments. There's no violins. It gives a very distinct color to the music. An interesting side note to this piece is that during the Second World War, all of the Brandenburg set of music was almost lost because it was sent on a train that was being sent to a place for safekeeping, and the Russians bombed the train, and the person that was actually in charge of the music escaped into the forest. So we're lucky we actually have it.
Thank you. Thank you.